So how did you bridge that? People come to me because I'm an awesome online marketer, and now here I am talking about something totally different.
That's what the part that felt so uncomfortable. I thought, this feels indulgent. And two, they don't want to hear about my struggles with finding balance with my husband and work, because when I talk about Hobie and the personal stuff and the arguments we've had about me being a workaholic and all of that, I felt indulgent, like I'm just talking about myself too much. So I had to kind of let that go. And the feedback is what helped me. So when you put yourself out there and you are more vulnerable, as long as you're doing it for the right reason, you want to show your audience what life really looks like. If you're doing it for the right reasons, it will come across that way. And listen to the feedback. And if that feedback is positive, you know you need to do more. So it was my audience telling me, I want more of that. That makes me understand you more. I get to see the realness, and it allows me to then look at you as my guide, as my teacher, because I get you both personally and professionally. We want to follow people that we like and we know and we trust. And so with that, sharing the personal stuff actually allows you to do better at the business stuff. I didn't know that till I started to do it. But I have more loyal fans in my business world because I've shared the behind the scenes of my private world. And I just believe that's human nature. And I didn't know it till I tried it.
Here's where I get unstuck. Is this like, be more authentic, be real, be you. Amy, this honestly, this is where I get a little judgmental, because I don't think posing 20 times to get the right light, to get the Instagram photo to look real is real.
I know. And it's a tough thing, because I was recently watching a documentary, and I won't get into the details, but it was all about this big fiasco that happened, and they were blaming a lot of it on social media being so fake, and they were using all these examples, and I was like, yeah, so much of it is fake, and if I'm being really honest, sometimes I contribute to that. Sometimes I do take 5, 6, 7 photos to find the best one to say, look at me just hanging out at home. Myself and say, Amy, that's not the real you. So that's why I push myself to really be as honest as possible. But I do find myself wanting to portray the Instagram life when it, I know it's a disservice to my students. So I really am open and I'm really cognizant of it to be careful of it. But I'm judgmental about it too. I see someone else, I'm like, really? That's really how you woke up? But then I thought, Amy, look at yourself. How many photos did you take before you posted that one? So I think it's a process is what I want to say. I think it's a journey, but I'm hoping that we're all moving toward being more real. And so Instagram really is real life and not the highlight reel.